By RightPath Real Estate does not necessarily represent the views or opinions of the staff, management, or ownership of this station. It's time to get on the right path with RightPath Real Estate Radio with Tom Perry. Get the answer to your question that's keeping you from taking action and succeeding today.
Your mic's live.
Get ready. The guide that will put your fears behind you is on the air now. Taking calls at 713-785-1817. Toll free 877-881-0271. Now here's your host, Tom Perry.
Hey, good morning. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. RightPath Real Estate Radio. It's Friday morning, February 22nd. It's kind of chilly in Houston.
We've had some really grayish weather.
Yeah, it's been kind of gray. And, you know, I always feel like it's a good start to the show. You know, the very first few minutes, we go live on Facebook about the time and accidentally clicked on the wrong button. I produce the video portion, I guess. When I say produce, you know, on Facebook. So you can go to fb.com/RightPath Real Estate. And I was on the Investors Game Day podcast on the event Wednesday night. That's a new thing. They're trying to do, you know, the Super Investor Real Estate Investing event. The third Wednesday of the month at the Redneck Country Club. They want to start doing kind of a pregame, like, you know, ESPN, Lee Corso kind of, you know, talking about. And so I was on that, and it's amazing, you know, over 1,000 views. And
yeah, I think close to 1,500. Yeah. And the setup looked real nice.
Yeah,
and
Andy did the setup. Yeah, Andy.
Our guy Andy did all that. So it's you know, knowing were you on the podcast, but, you know, we were detrimental in helping get it set up. So it's always nice
Not
to...
Not detrimental. Instrumental.
You're right. I did say detrimental. Those are backwards. We were instrumental, not detrimental.
And then, you know, I always feel like there's so much going on right at the start of the show because, you know, I'm trying to... You know, I want to share on my personal page that the show is going on, and then I want to get the Facebook going up on my laptop, and then sometimes, you know, like my daughter was on my laptop last night because she was doing her homework. She was up till like 1 o'clock in the morning doing her homework.
Really?
Yeah, she's got her first big research paper is due.
Okay.
And so she's having to, you know, cite the references, and so that's supposed to be on index cards. So she had to do 35 citings last night on index cards.
Okay. So she was honest with me because when she came to go start helping us set up, I said, "Hey, are you done with your homework?"
Yeah.
And she said, "I've done all I can do until I get index cards."
Correct.
And my dad has those.
Yep. Right.
I said, "Okay, I'm going to trust you."
We actually picked up index cards on the way home, and so she's got enough index cards to last a while now. She's got, yeah. And so she was completely, she had done everything except for the index cards. But that part, I mean.
It takes forever.
Well, and I stayed up with her. And she was so sweet. She's like, "Thanks, Dad, for staying up." And so we got to bed about 1 o'clock last night. So topic of conversation for today is, who do you turn to when you get stuck? And... you know, do you already have a go-to person? And what I would say is, you know, my network is large enough that it depends on the area that I get stuck. Because, you know, everyone gets stuck. Nothing to be ashamed of. In fact, what I find, one of the things that unsuccessful people do is try and hide the fact that they get stuck.
Absolutely, they do.
Because they want to feel like they're the expert in everything. And, you know, it's kind of, I don't want to get political. But when you realize that, like, our political process is and the interviews and the way the news media works, it's almost like they're always playing the game of gotcha.
Yeah.
And when you think about all the things that, like, the president has his hands in, you know, which is foreign policy and economic, I mean, just on and on and on, and you've got to know all of history, you know, it's like, I mean, and all the relationships, and it's like, you know, no one person can be an expert. Now you can be familiar with all that, but it's, I mean, if you're an expert in economics, that's pretty much all you do. You eat, breathe, sleep, drink,
absolutely,
you know, economics. And then, you know, you have the people that are on the, you know, in the cabinet that are all the war heroes, right? I mean, the military leaders. And it's like, those guys eat, they're not dreaming economics. They're not eat, sleep, and drink.
They're dreaming strategy.
They're dreaming, you know, putting the hurt on people, right?
Absolutely.
And so it's like to be at that level, to be an expert in something, it's typically at the exclusion of everything else.
Yeah.
I mean, we've talked about that in sports before. You know that the great Olympian swimmer, Michael Phelps.
Yeah,
that guy. And you know, he's an expert in swimming.
Yes.
He's not also a tennis star.
No.
He's not also a great golfer.
Is that to say he's not athletic?
No, right.
No, not at all.
Right.
But in order to be a 10 at something at such a high level, and that's one of the
things. You think he's an expert in finance?
Probably not.
I'm
sure he's got a guy.
Yeah, you got,
right?
He's got a guy.
And right. You know, a lot of times you hear people say, oh, you know, they give you that little chart with all the 8-10 different areas of your life. And they're like, you know, how do you balance those things out? Well, do you want to be mediocre at everything in your life? It's not physically possible to be a 10 at everything you do.
It's not.
You have to focus on what you're good at and find people that are good at the things you're not.
Right.
And that's how you get through.
So, yeah, so we get back to your network. And then what I find is that if you're stuck someplace, you know, do you have a network that pulls you up to a higher level? I mean, like, you know, they say that you're typically the average of the five people that you hang out with the most in terms of you'll dress similar, you'll talk similar, you know, your vocabulary, all that. Your thinking will be similar. And what I find is when people get stuck, they oftentimes turn to their friends and family.
Of course.
Which, you know, almost always think exactly, you know, like you think. And so if you can't get yourself unstuck, which you obviously cannot, anybody that gets stuck someplace, then you cannot get yourself unstuck. If you could,
you never would have gotten stuck to begin with.
Yeah, right.
Absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. And it's a little bit like saying, you know, you mentioned the other day that about if, you know, if you lose your keys.
Yeah.
You know, and there's all, you know, obviously comedians can poke a lot of fun about people losing stuff, right? And how, you know, one of my favorite jokes is, you know, things are always the last place, you know, that you look.
Yeah.
You find them always the last place that you look. And like, yeah, because, duh, we stop looking, right? Yeah,
absolutely.
Only an idiot would
keep looking after you found them.
Yeah. Yeah, so I've done that a couple of times just to be able to see, told you it wasn't the last place. Just kidding.
But it's like when you lose something, right? And somebody goes, well, where's the last place you had it?
Yeah, right.
Well, if I knew the last place I had it, yeah, they wouldn't be lost.
Well, I've already looked the last place that I remembered having it,
yes,
and it's not
of
there.
Of course.
And then, like when you're looking for your glasses and they're on top of your head.
I mean, I've run from room to room hearing having somebody call my cell phone,
yeah,
so I can hear it ring and find out where it's at, and I'm chasing it from room to room, but it's in my back pocket.
Yeah. So Ginger says, love to find that go-to person. About the time I think I've got one, they show me they're not the real person. I struggle some, but usually find my way. I'm missing my mojo, trying to locate my groove. Yeah. Well, here's what I can tell you is, there are experts out there. I mean, in the area of real estate. I mean, I believe that you know, I'm a go-to person, and one of the frustrating. I tell you what, when you are people's go-to person, there's a timing in which you should be going to that go-to person.
We talked about this very thing last night in our room.
I'll tell you something. When you're a go-to person for someone, and there are very few things that are more frustrating for being the go-to person than somebody brings you this issue, but they're not bringing you the issue at the beginning of the issue being presented. They're bringing, because they're not asking you, hey, I've got a decision to make, and you know, I've got to choose between A or B. What they're typically doing is they're coming to you after they've already decided between A and B, and it went poorly.
Yes.
And then now they're not bringing you in on the decision making process. They're bringing you in on how do I clean it up? A decision that's gone poorly, which is a whole different set of being stuck.
Yes.
Yeah. So the question is, you know, when you look at different areas of your life, you know, like health, for example, do you have a go-to person for health? You know, somebody in our office was just recently talking about, you know, losing weight.
Yeah.
And they said, you know, the keto diet is really popular, just, you know, all fat, no carbs. And then there's, you know, the high protein diet. I mean, it's all the different diets, right?
Yeah.
And I said, look, dieting's really not the way to go. I mean, when you and I got into a conversation about which muscle groups to work, you know, that, you know, if I were a cadaver and was being, you know, autopsied, they weigh different organs and things like that, and so if they were to cut out my bicep, you know, because I know my arms are huge and all, but nobody's bicep, even Arnold Schwarzenegger's bicep, is not that heavy.
Yeah.
And if he grows, let's say it's, you know, pound, 2 pounds, something like that, and you grow up by 10%, it's not that much.
Yeah.
And yet your quadriceps, your hamstrings, your glutes, though you grow those by 10%, you've really increased the engine of your metabolism. Those are the cells, you know, your muscle cells are what burn calories.
2 minutes.
And so people want to talk about, you know, I want to lose some fat. Well, you don't lose fat.
Yeah, you, you
know,
burn it.
Yeah, a comedian again, you know, hey, I think I lost some fat. Well, turn around and think I found it. You obviously haven't, you started, you quit looking too early. I think yeah. I found it. So any, just, come on, I'm being funny. But you don't lose it, you burn it.
Yeah.
You know, that's like saying, hey, I don't lose gasoline. Your car doesn't lose gasoline. It
absolutely
burns. It burns
gasoline. And I wasn't aware of the muscle thing. But I can tell you, do you want to know what I've been focusing on since you've made me aware of that?
Doing squats, doing deadlifts.
Focusing on those three muscles.
Right.
Absolutely.
Right.
Because I didn't know before. I was spacing it out and spending equal time on everything.
Yeah.
Right?
Which is not...
It's so simple.
Right.
Now that you've explained it to me.
Well, but here's the issue. Because the other thing is that if you get so singularly focused on, like, let's say I know people have gone in, they'll just work their hamstrings and they'll just work their quads day after day after day. And what happens? You have to work it strong
absolutely.
Enough where you tear it down, give it 2 to 3 days to recover.
Understand
and,
that
and
process.
Then hit it again. Right. So,
absolutely.
Anyhow. All right. So you're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. I want to give out our phone number, 713-785-1817. 713-785-1817. And we'll talk a little bit more about last night's event because, you know, we know that there's a lot of teaching going on out there.
Yeah.
Some of it's good. Some of it's not so good. We want to talk about, you know, Matt's story last night.
Man, what a great job.
You know, he's just such a great human.
He's a really good guy.
Yeah, when you start realizing that the kind of people that we're attracting are people with high character, high integrity, you know, I love the way our group is growing. So you're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. The music says I'm out of time for this segment. I'll be back in 4 minutes. I hope you'll stay with us. Be right back.
Good morning, Christina. Good morning, Billy. Good morning, Andy, Aaron, Nikki, Steve, Sonia, Ginger.
If your insurance company
Marty.
Is non-responsive,
good morning, Ashley. Hope you're feeling better this morning.
You need a quick turnaround.
Jew from Arkansas. Good morning.
For that is Benchmark Insurance.
Ginger, always a pleasure.
Benchmark understands.
Erica, good morning.
They know what you need.
Jeff, what's up? Juan, good morning.
Call Houston's leading real estate risk management experts, Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Chris Swain, what's
Hello,
going on, man?
Investors, do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment?
John, good morning.
Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor
Networking
meeting.
I didn't fix my shake this morning.
Meeting.
No?
Fun, no.
Lots of great
you know,
real estate talk.
A few extra things on my on my agenda this morning.
Yeah.
Get my daughter up ready for school and walking the dog. And
are you looking for an investor?
My daughter woke up with her
for
mouth just
property?
Killing her. She went
then
to the orthodontist yesterday
model.
Thinking
oh,
she
yeah.
was get her braces off. And then not only did she not get them off, they...
Or reach us on the web.
So apparently some people, when they swallow, they move their tongue
specializes in turnkey
to the back
of
their teeth.
Single-family investment properties, whether it's a flip
yeah.
rehab
so,
or a
so
rental
like,
rehab,
right
we
now.
Manage every
so,
aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a
no,
high
no.
Yeah, so apparently it's a habit.
Over the
that
last
you,
6 years,
the people that do it, it's a habit they've developed for a long period of time.
Projects,
and, morning, Andrew.
Which has helped
and
us
then,
to create our three keys
so she's
to
got
success.
These rubber bands. So when
Here's
her teeth, they want
so
the top
done,
teeth are kind of overlapping like that. They want it down just a little
so
bit more.
Right,
but so the rubber bands are pulling it down a little bit, but her teeth hitting on the back, so that's counterbalancing what the rubber band is supposed to be doing. So it's not. So that's fighting, and she can't do anything about the tongue. And she said, well, can't you just cut it out a little? Just kidding. I love her sense of humor.
It's tied to the front of my teeth.
So she's got these two bands that she's supposed to wear all the time, and then this other one band that wraps all, and she wore that all night last night. She's supposed to wear it all the time, and she's not in school or eating or something like that, and she's just
sore, huh?
misery.
Call Foundation
yeah.
Check for a truly
so ibuprofen also. All that came before.
Evaluation.
Which always makes it fun for dad.
Yeah, right.
When they're in misery.
Yeah. She's so amazing.
1,400 evaluations. We're not in the business of repairing.
I know everybody thinks their daughter's amazing.
Or selling you unnecessary peer work.
So we you didn't so much when you was Dr. Keith.
Our product is designed for house flippers.
You know, she's
even owner-occupied properties.
She's the third out of my four children.
Yeah.
To do that.
Is that right?
So it's kind of like, hey, just sit here by the car. I'll be back at some point. With the, you know, and it wasn't like he could just pull up, right? So he's driving around. I'm having to chase him down in the parking lot because he couldn't find my Jeep.
Yeah.
Then I got to walk him through the building to get to the car. It was fun.
Yeah. Good times.
Yeah.
That's how memories are made.
This is Business 1110.
More cowbell.
Mic's on.
Hey, welcome back, Right Path Real Estate Radio. Welcome to the show. So, you know, this has been a busy week.
It has been a crazy week.
You know, we did the Wealth Through Real Estate workshop was Tuesday night.
Yeah.
And then we normally do one on Thursday in the afternoon, but we didn't because we did it Thursday evening.
Yeah.
Once a month, we do it in the evening time on a Thursday, and it's also a case study where we highlight. You know, here's what I can tell you is, I can talk about the things that I've accomplished, and really it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
What I would rather talk about is the thing that our students accomplish. And, you know, it's fascinating because, like, Matt drove up from Corpus. It's so funny. Guests sitting on the front row saying, you know, and he's dressed. He's a cowboy from the word go. He is just through and through, lives in Corpus Christi or just outside of there. And, you know, through and through, he's a cowboy. Like the real deal, you know, he's not a pretender.
No.
And he goes, so the person, you're ready for the rodeo? And he's like, no, what are you talking about? Like,
rodeo, what? This is how I dress every day.
Well, because, you know, people that aren't in Houston, you know, everybody in Houston knows rodeo.
Absolutely.
It's rodeo time right now.
That is so funny.
The chili cook-off. He's like, no, this is just me. This is every day.
I can't believe somebody said that.
Right. It was funny. And he's so, oh, my gosh, he's so humble. And, you know, when you look at where he was when he came in.
Yes.
And having spent, you know, he shared last night he had spent over $50,000 with another real estate education group and was still stuck and had gotten coaching calls. And they had sent him, you know, what he realized is that all the things that they had asked him to do in terms of building business credit and doing all these other things.
Entities and all the structure.
Yeah, building these very complicated. And what he realized is that all that was just to sell because they get a kickback on all their.
Of course, affiliate marketing.
Yeah, and so they were just getting paid on item after item, which is not really what he needed. And you know what we want to do first is just sit down with people and say, hey, where are you trying to get to?
Yeah,
and then let's design. You know, because his journey is different because he's got a unique set of circumstances. I mean, he's bought, you know, property in Sandia, which, I mean, I was like, I've been living in Texas a long time. And, you know, where is Sandia? And
your story about Direct Texas, that was so. And then the other guy goes, it's right next to
Mathis.
Right? Mathis. You said, well, that clears it up for everybody.
So I shared this story last night that, you know, when I went off to A&M, went to college, and I lived on campus. I lived in Davis Gary, not that anybody really cares other than Aggies, so I'm sharing it for them because they're really all who matters.
Yeah, that's all that matters.
No, isn't that right, Steve? So Steve just joined us, and he's a good Aggie, and his daughter's great and all that. So so first semester freshman year, I had kind of a country boy roommate, you know, Justin Powers.
Okay.
And, you know, lived in La Porte all his life. I mean, he was into trucks and had worked at a body shop, and so had custom painted this candy apple red.
Okay.
You know, lots of layers of lack. I mean, he's talking a different language. I mean,
we
were from the same hometown, essentially, Greater Houston area, but we were from totally different worlds and got along well. I mean, you know, he's a guy that could get along with anybody, and so am I.
Yeah.
And but he had a tough time with the discipline of studying.
Okay.
So he decided at the end of our first semester freshman year, he moved out. I got a new roommate spring semester because he went and joined the Corps. Justin did.
Okay.
So then, you know, for a lot of people, what they do is they'll co-op. You know, go to start in the fall freshman year, and then the second semester they work.
Okay.
If something related to their major, then summer they go to school, then the fall they work, then spring they go to, so it's every other, they're rotating. So typically you can get your degree in 5 years instead of four, And but then you also have, you know, a lot of work experience as well. Yeah. You've got half of that time as work experience. Okay. So this guy, he was a fifth-year senior. He was coming back for his last semester, was going to be graduating, and he was an electrical engineering major and had been working for General Dynamics ever since he was a freshman, working on the computers for the F-16.
Oh,
designing
fun.
The circuit board computers. Wow. Yeah, I mean, great guy. And he was country and from a little bitty town. And so when we first meet, you know, he got this drawing. He goes, hey, my name is... You know, and so all of that. I said, where are you from? And he goes, I'm from a little place you probably never heard of called Direct, Texas. I'm like, yeah, you got me there. I've never heard of that. And I go, what's it close to? And he goes, oh, it's pretty close to telephone. And I'm like, you're gonna have to keep going because he's still, you know, a reference of one a place is that another reference that you don't know is not very helpful, right?
Yeah.
And he goes, well, probably the closest place you'd ever, you know. And I found it on a map, you know. And Direct, Texas, not on the way to anything. I mean, you don't pass it going.
There's no reason you ever would.
No, right. Never.
Unless you were going there.
Yeah, unless you're going there, you don't get there any other way.
So Steve says on the Book of Faces, Tom, you and Daniel have been very helpful to us and have saved and made us a lot of money by not making stupid mistakes. Appreciate you guys being our stuck guys.
Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate that.
Thanks, Steve. That's amazing.
Yeah, thanks. I appreciate that. So you know, that's really what and everybody gets stuck in different places. And getting stuck doesn't mean that you're not smart.
No, not at all.
No.
I mean, we get stuck in doing what we're doing on a daily basis. And, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be real estate, right? But sometimes it is.
Like, I know a lot about marketing and real estate, but, you know, marketing in other areas, I'm not an expert.
Oh, yeah.
And so when you realize what it takes to be an expert in marketing, for example, I mean, like, we've got a great Google AdWords and Facebook marketing guy.
Yeah.
And, I mean, that's what he does, you know, every day, probably 10, 12 hours a day, 5, 6, 7 days a week. I mean, he owns his own business. But he doesn't know website design.
No.
And he doesn't really – and he knows about ad placement and things like that, but he's not really the content guy. So when you start looking at all the people it takes and the skill sets that are necessary and get that to mesh together, it's like, wow, that's – you could spend all your time, and some people do. They call them marketing people.
Absolutely.
So,
spend all their time on it.
Yeah, and so, you know, you realize that a guy like a Mattress Mac, for example, I mean, he probably knows a lot about marketing, but he outsources that to the people that attends.
Absolutely.
I tell you what he does know is he knows people, he knows customer relations, he knows how to move some furniture.
Absolutely.
Right. He knows about how to do on-time delivery, he knows about logistics, all those kind of things. But you can't be – no one can be a 10 on everything.
Yeah.
So then, you know, how do you build your network? And are you building a network to take from someone else's knowledge, or are you building a network to build relationships that are long-term? Because if you're really focused on, you know, like I was sharing with some people last night. It was so great. I've talked to Matt a bunch.
Yeah.
But it's been a long time since I've seen him face-to-face.
Yeah.
And I think the last time I saw him face-to-face may have been when I went and spoke at his real estate group, right, down in Corpus.
Yeah. And that was, what, 4 or 5 months ago, right?
About that. I mean, okay. I have to think in terms of that Point Comfort House. And so, yeah, maybe about that. But it's so great, and I feel like there's a great relationship there. And it's not about our success. It's really about his success. And when he started sharing last night, and there was a guy on the front row that was a guest last night, and he said, you know, Matt, I've seen you speak before, and you just seem like such a humble person and such a, you know.
Down-to-earth guy is what he said.
Down-to-earth guy, right. And he said, but, you know, Matt in the last, like, 2 or 3 years has added over $600,000 to his net worth.
He said, Matt, I'm looking at your numbers.
And you're rock
star. And that's rock star stuff.
Right, but
he. Here's the funny part. So he sent Andy all the information.
Right, sure, right.
Right?
Yeah.
So Andy spent 4 hours yesterday putting the information in a deliverable form.
Right.
And I don't think Matt had ever taken the time to put his numbers together.
Right.
Right? He knew he had the numbers for each deal. There were a couple times when the totals came up that he was like, okay, I'm not doing too bad, right? And you could see it on his face. It's like, you want to talk about a humble guy.
Yeah.
He doesn't even realize the amount of equity and success and things he's had over the past, 18, 24 months. And it's just like, wow.
Yeah, like the last 2 to 3 years, he's added over $600,000 to his net worth. And you realize, man, and I tell you what, I get jazzed. I mean, I get more excited about him than if that happened to me.
Oh, of course.
Because I want to be, because... And then we talked a little bit about what the ulterior motive, like some people ask us, well, Tom, why do you teach everything that you know? And it's like, well, here's the real reason why. I know that I can help somebody make $500,000-$600,000 in a couple of years, or sometimes over $1 million in a year. We have one student made over $1.5 million in the 12 months that he was in that since he started with us. It just in equity capture alone.
Yes.
And another $200,000 in appreciation he'll get year after year.
Another $100,000 in cash flow.
Right. And again, these results are not typical. Got to give that disclaimer. And your results may vary and, blah, 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 blah. All the legal stuff.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, but they
are. Cover my tail, because not everybody's gotten those results, but not everybody's done the same efforts.
Yep.
What I'll tell you is the math works. And that's one of the things that Matt was sharing last night, is that you really have to trust the math.
Yeah.
But here's the ulterior motive. You build your network in the good times so that the buying opportunities exist when things get tough. And then that's when financing dries up, and that's when we can all as a group, if we pull our money together and as a group go out and start buying assets when nobody else wants to buy them.
Yeah.
Right now I think everybody wants to buy multifamily. And so, is there a deal every now and then in a secondary or tertiary market? Yes, there is. But are you taking into consideration the travel time and all those other things to go and get those deals when, you can get some great appreciation, great returns in single family that you can do more deals faster than working on a deal that's...
Yeah, it's taking you 3 weeks to just figure out what the numbers are and getting it down to be able to even make a decision. Right.
And so what I'm looking for is, like, we I've mentioned this before, we know the guy that owned the building that we were in before, and we had a chance. He wanted to be a private money lender. We'd had numerous occasions to meet with him, and he shared one time that he bought the building that we were in back in the 80s during a crash. And when it crashes, that's a buying opportunity. It was a vacant building and it needed some work, and he picked it up for like $30 a foot. Now, that's still a lot of money. I mean, it's 120,000 square feet. But when you're looking at, I think it's appraised recently at like $180 a foot.
Wow.
And he was actually charging rent of $30 a foot a year. I mean, so he's getting as much a year in rent as what he paid for the property. Now, he had to go in and spend some money on rehabbing and things like that, but that's where you build. And that guy went through a crash and went through a buying spree.
Yeah.
And now today
he was buying them for cash. He wasn't getting financed. They weren't offering.
So now he's a self-made centimillionaire.
Yes.
Which for those of y'all, that's $100 million.
$100 million.
And so, you don't get to $100 million by making, $600,000 in 2 years or things like just and do, you don't do that. What it takes being prepared for when that opportunity. So it takes having a great network.
Yes.
You don't build your network when that happens. You prepare for the harvest before the crop is ready, right? So that might be biblical, but anyhow. So you're listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. The music says I'm out of time, and I will be back in 4 minutes. I hope you will be too. Thanks for listening. Well, you can tell it's rodeo time.
Do you have cracks?
Morning, Raymond. Derek, good morning.
Or sheetrock that's coming apart. Then you may have foundation.
Good morning, Mrs. Perry.
Due to our expansive soils in the Houston area,
Derek,
not a question of
Mike,
if you have movement, but when. Call Foundation Check for a truly independent,
Elizabeth, good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Evaluation. Foundation Check has been in business since 2009 and has completed over 1,400 evaluations. We're not in the business of repairing foundations or selling you unnecessary peer work, but we are in the business of evaluating your foundation.
Oh.
Our product is designed for house flippers,
this is the first commercial. I'm going to take a quick break.
Even right. Owner-occupied properties. Each of our files is reviewed by a licensed engineer. Remember to check before every repair. Call
346-702-3525. Oh, wait. Let me grab my keys.
That's 346-702-3525.
Morning, Juan.
Or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com.
Give us some likes and loves and shares, everybody. We appreciate
it.
Kelly, good morning.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount.
Jet David Deere, how are you, brother?
Fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders? The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
1 minute.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done
that's,
right,
that's different.
And complete the work in a proper order so it gets done
that's
fast.
A little wave going, man.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does
manage
fresh
haircut, it all. Who knows what
so
it's
give us
do.
A call
my,
today.
My youngest is going through this thing with the 742 front of his hair. He's trying to, he wants it to look a certain way.
Again, that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
You're going to have to chill out a little bit. It's like you're overdoing it. Well, it looks good when it's this way. It was like you're 11. It doesn't matter.
Hey, David, what's going on, man?
Mike's on.
Mike's are on. Welcome back, Right Path Real Estate Radio. So we're talking about who do you turn to when you get stuck? And, I actually have four different people that I turn to, depending on what area it is that I'm stuck in. And what I realize is each one of them is so different because they're so totally immersed in being an expert about what it is that they do.
Yeah.
That, well, I tell you, you know what? I take that back. It's more than four. Because we've got four just in marketing alone.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, that's...
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and then when I look at, you know, from a legal standpoint, and then from a you know, just a life standpoint,
yes.
You know, and there, and then from a health standpoint, I mean, that... It's like, wow, when you get stuck, who do you turn to? What people don't realize is that the longer you wait... To go to that person.
The harder it is to get it fixed.
It is.
Yeah. And then a lot of people waste so much time going, you know, like at the beginning you talked about, you know, people in their circle.
Yeah.
Right? Their neighbors or their family members. They're going to people that think the same way they do.
Right.
And if they're going to people that think the same way they do.
Right.
They're going to give them a solution that they could have come up with on their own that obviously doesn't work anyway because those you need somebody that is not. In the same thought process, in the same place in life as you, because that person is just as susceptible to be stuck where you are.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, I don't want somebody that thinks just like I do.
Yeah.
To go to, and because then it's like, you know, because if they've got ideas like mine, I mean, and my ideas, you know, aren't what's getting me unstuck, then you're going to stay stuck.
You're not looking for somebody that is parallel.
Right.
Or right next to you,
right.
on that path, right?
Right?
You're looking for somebody who's down the path ahead of you,
right?
Not behind you, not where you are. You want somebody that's further along on that path. They've got more expertise in that area, or you know, more wisdom in life, whatever
you're
the
right.
situation is. Otherwise, you're just getting bad information,
right? So, So anyhow, that's the topic of the conversation today is where do you turn when you get stuck? Now, I also want to talk about, you know, I see people make decisions that aren't necessarily aligned with their goals because they make the decisions about what it is that they want to do prior to establishing where they're trying to get to.
Yes.
And an analogy that we use a lot is, you know, I talk about three different types of vehicles. I talk about an airplane as a vehicle, a car as a vehicle, and a bicycle as a vehicle. And then I ask people, it's a little bit of a setup.
Yeah. You did it the other night at our Wealth Through Income, Wealth Through Real Estate workshop. You
Correct.
Asked the lady, hey, what's the best of these three
and
vehicles?
She goes, well, of course, a plane.
A plane.
Because it gets you fast. They're faster. And I said, okay, so I want you to imagine, I want to set a plane. You're going to probably bring it in by crane or something, right? But want to set a plane right in front of our office building. And I want you to take that plane just across the freeway to go to get some gasoline.
Yeah.
And she goes, oh, well, that wouldn't be a very good use of that plane. I go, exactly.
Yeah.
So you picked the vehicle before you looked at where am I starting and where am I going to. I've asked that question before of people that go, oh, well, I don't really like airplanes, so I like cars better. And then I say, well, then you'll probably never visit Hawaii.
Nope.
Because now until they build that railroad track to Hawaii then and get rid of all planes and things like that, then I guess
it's going to be a while.
Except for plane, I mean, it you can get there pretty fast by plane, relatively speaking.
Yeah.
Faster, you can get there by boat also.
You can.
Can't get there by car.
No.
So
unless you drive your car on a boat or plane.
Once you set the destination and you look at where am I starting, because let's say that somebody says, well, I want to go to Honolulu. But what if you're in the town right next door, that's your starting place?
There you go.
Then you might pick a different vehicle on how to get there,
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
So now if you're in Houston and you want to go to Honolulu, then, you know, you probably take a plane.
Yeah. And I think that's what's broken with real estate education as a whole.
Yeah.
Right? Well, that's why we're so different than most of these other programs, because most of these other programs are assuming everybody is starting in Houston trying to get to Honolulu.
Right.
Right, so they can give you the exact answer you need for that. Here, get on this plane and take it. But they're not accounting for the fact that some people are already in Hawaii, you know, in the next town over. They're not accounting for the fact that some people are on the East Coast, right? It's so they're not finding out where people are, and they're assuming their destination for them.
Well, one of the things that Matt was sharing last night is that's one of the reasons why he was stuck, is he had gone to this other real estate education company and had spent a ton of money with them. And he'd gotten a backpack, and it had all the information in it. You know, the binder's full of stuff, and he read through all of that, but it didn't really. There were some key critical factors that he's like, I don't know how to deal with these things that are unique to me.
Yeah,
because he's starting at a different place. And in fact, we had a very diverse group in our room last night, and when I looked around at all the people in the room, and I said, you know, hey, if I were going to ask each of y'all where you want to go on vacation this summer. You know, I'm probably going to get, I'm not going to get just one answer.
No, absolutely not.
And so by the same token, if I said, hey, I want to interview each one of you and you tell me where you want to be financially a year from now, 3 years from now, 5 years from now, then I'm not going to get the same answer on that either.
Not.
But more importantly is that, so we're going to all have different endpoints, but if I interviewed you and said, well, what kind of time resources and money resources and life experience you know, do you have? What kind of business experience? Have you ever run your own business? Have you ever, you know, those kind of things? Have you ever been in sales and marketing? That kind of stuff. So when you get to all that, if you're starting in a different place and you're ending in a different place, how can anybody have the same path to go from A to B?
And not only that, but, you know, you bring up a good point.
Rick, are you there?
I think we lost. Yeah, but you're not. No,
you
are.
Okay. Oh, it must have an inconsistent signal then? That's always entertaining.
Yeah, fun.
Yeah, that's fun.
You bring up a good point that everybody's starting with a different set of resources, a different set of life skills and things like that. So even if they all had the same goal,
right,
even if their destination was all the same, the plan to get there is not going to be the same. It's going to be a different, you know, a different mode of travel, a different route, if you will.
Right.
Because not everybody's going to be able to get there in the same amount of time because they have different resources and things like that. So that's another thing that we do is we're upfront and honest with you. Hey, you know, your goal for next year to make $1 million,
right?
Being that you've never made 40 before, that might
and you've
be,
got no money and no time.
Exactly, that might be a little far fetched, right?
Well, and there was a young lady sitting on the front row last night, and I said, hey, how long? First off, are you doing real estate? And she said, not yet. And I said, how long have you been, you know, dreaming or talking about doing real estate? She goes, at least a year. And I said, well, what's kept you from taking action? She goes, well, you don't understand. I've got a full-time job. Mm. And I said, well, you're going to enjoy tonight then.
Yeah.
But you're going to have a little bit of a problem. And she goes, what's that? And I said, well, you're going to see a person that also has a full-time job that, in spite of that, has achieved a tremendous amount of success.
Yes.
And so you will no longer be able to use that as an excuse. You'll have to find a new excuse to not have success. I mean, yeah. Some people, they're their own worst enemy.
Absolutely.
In terms Absolutely. Of, and it comes in a variety of different ways that it sounds. Oh, well, I've got to learn a lot more because I don't want to make a mistake. I got to become an expert before I do it.
Of course.
Well, can I tell you, you'll with that as an attitude, you'll never ever get success because you'll never get started because you'll never. There's always something else that you can learn.
There is.
I mean, the marketplace is constantly changing.
Yeah, there's new stuff every day.
I mean, can you imagine if you said, "Hey, I've got to know everything about medicine before I ever actually see a patient"? If you were a medical doctor.
Yeah, you'd be waiting a long time.
Well, and because there's always something new to learn. Yeah. There's always things that are new being created. There's
the market shifts. There's breakthroughs. There's...
Yeah, so you're never going to master it all before... So if that's what you're waiting on, you've just really given yourself a great excuse.
Yeah, I mean, like, absolutely.
A great excuse.
Absolutely.
Now, it doesn't help you reach your goals. So which do you want to let go of, your goals or your excuses?
Yeah. And I think a lot of times people will take excuses that they feel like they can't control.
Yeah, of course.
That way they're not personally responsible.
Right.
Right? And I would argue that you are.
Yes.
Because you're, you know, my daughter and I woke up a little bit late this morning.
Yes.
Right? Now, I could have skipped going to the gym.
Yep, you could have.
And had her where she needed to be on time and been where I needed to be on time.
Right.
But I chose not to do that.
Right.
And... I made a post and I said, obstacles will always show up in your life.
Oh my God,
but
yeah.
You get to choose whether or not you make that obstacle an excuse.
Absolutely. That's a great post. I'll have to share that one later. So we're also waiting on having a reserve in cash. Yeah, which is, again, another great excuse. I don't have the money to do it. Yet I know other people. In fact, how many of the properties did Matt do where he had absolutely new, because Andy did a great job of creating.
It was over half.
It was like,
yeah, it was like 7 out of 12.
Right. No money out of pocket.
Yeah.
And funding it all with private money lenders. So, I mean, that's that, and they're not requiring a reserve of cash. And then I've also seen people that have put together buy and hold portfolios where one person brings the money. And, you know, I've never been a big fan of people partnering on a flip deal, because if you ever run the math between what it costs for partnering, where you're splitting the profits, where one person's bringing the money, if you've got a $50,000 flip deal and you're splitting the profits on that, and the guy's getting $25,000 just for providing
very
the money,
expensive money,
that is way more expensive than the most expensive of hard money lenders. And so the math just doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
However, if you're going to do either an equity participation mortgage or partner with someone on a single family buy and hold property where they're lending to you for like 5 years or something like that, then that's something, you know, different entirely.
Yeah.
One of the things that Matt's been doing is setting up on the front end, hey, he borrows money because he's a buy and hold investor.
Yep.
And he's got all these deals. He's gained over $600,000 in captured equity and no money out of pocket on 2/3 of the deals. And so if you're waiting on reserves, you're just letting that be an excuse.
And here's another thing. It's like I get so many people, even at Redneck,
yeah,
you know, some people in our group I was having a conversation with last night, and it's they're trying to get the money before they get a deal.
Yes, 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 yes.
And that's not. You're doing it backwards.
Yeah, the deal makes the money easy.
Go get the deal. The money is the easy part.
Yeah.
If you've got what's a really, and you know what a deal is, and you know, unless you're lying to yourself, but if you've got a deal and you're having trouble finding money for that deal,
yeah,
give me a holler.
Yeah.
Hey,
the music says we're out of time. We got to go to a break. We're going to continue that on the other side. 4 minutes. We'll be right back.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm a rocket man. Rocket man.
Time is money in a real estate.
You probably don't want me to keep going.
If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders? The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10
years. This one?
No, right below.
Insure over 30,000
properties. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you
what we can do for you. I wonder if I get the invite this year.
281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Selecting a foundation company and their product for repair is a lot like a game of chance. You simply don't know what you're going to get. The foundation repair industry as a whole doesn't carry a license, nor is it regulated. However, Foundation Check utilizes professional engineers to review all of our files to give you the best foundation analysis in today's market. Remember to check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825, or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mics are on.
Hey, welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-785-1817. I want to tell people that, are there any seats left for this weekend? Because I know we had to move to a bigger room.
We did. Maybe three.
Okay.
Maybe three.
So
it's going to be tight.
We're gonna be doing the Wealth Through Real Estate Academy this weekend. It's all day Saturday, all day Sunday. It's 16 hours with me teaching how built Houston house buyers to buy, fix, and flip, wholesale, and buy and hold. We're going to be spending one full day about all the things that you need to know that are critical, like must knows, in terms of finding deals, analyzing deals, estimating rehabs, selling deals, all that kind of stuff. Everything, soup to nuts that you need. I mean, I don't leave anything on the table or in inside the tank. It's all poured out.
You give it all you've got.
I give it all I got. Come into the day Sunday, I'm exhausted.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then Sunday. It's going to be about how to do it passively.
Yeah.
Because what we really attract two different crowds. One crowd is the oil and gas guy or the CPA, somebody that's has saved a lot of money, and they're looking at their 401k and they're going, well, I'm 52 years old and I got like $300,000 in there and I got to get to like 1.6, 2 million, and I'm not even sure that that's enough.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's taken me all this time to get here, and there's not enough time based on, unless I just want to go through the roof in terms of risk. And even that, it's like, it could probably go, 300 could go to 150,
I mean,
right?
At some point, compounding is not going to bail you out.
Right. So then it's like, how do I play catch up? And then when they realize that real estate, I mean, there's people making, $600,000 in 18 months or $1.5 million in a year, that kind of stuff. And again, results are not typical, and there's a disclaimer. But it's doable.
Absolutely.
We show a $150,000 house, and not only that, we've had people that are wanting help finding those deals, and we're in the process of putting together the Asset Buyers Club.
Absolutely.
To where we are full time real estate, and we find those kind of deals and we create those kind of deals. When I say there's a difference between finding a deal and creating a deal, the way a lot of people do on MLS is they're trying to find a deal.
Yes.
They set up their filters, things like that, and then they'll look at a deal. And here's a house for should be worth 150, and it needs 30,000 in repairs, so it's for sale for 120. You know, because
they're like, oh, that doesn't work, and they're on to the next one.
Right, and then, but I mean, how close is it? Would it work at what number would it work? Would it work at 110? At 105? I mean, it's in the ballpark, right? I mean, it's not retail ready, so it needs to be bought by an investor. Why not you?
And then again, you know, you can ask yourself this: even at 120,
yeah, right.
Who says it's not a deal?
You're right.
If you're looking for cash flow, I guarantee you that's going to be a deal.
Right. And so there's so many different gauges in real estate. And if you want to start recognizing that, you know, you can buy based on appreciation, you can buy based on equity capture, you can buy based on cash flow. But the more you push in one direction, the oftentimes you're giving it's hard to get all three of those. And then it's at what level? So it's kind of like, are you doing base hits? Are you doing grand slam home runs? You know, everybody wants to hit a grand slam. But you know what's even better than hit a grand slam home run is when it's game seven, World Series, bottom of the ninth, you know, you're behind by three runs, it needs, you know, and it's two outs, you know, and the bases are loaded, now, you know,
two minutes.
You're up to bat,
right? Yeah, they make movies out of that kind of
stuff. Yeah, of course, right. How many times in the history of baseball has that actually happened?
Exactly.
There's a stat out there for that,
yep,
right?
Absolutely.
But if you're trying to build your business model on that, I mean, I've talked about, you know, Discount Tire. How long does it take them to change? Not the weight to get into, but once your car is brought into the bay, start to finish. You know, they have tires in stock. How long does it take those guys to change a set of tires?
30 minutes.
I mean, why so long? I mean, NASCAR guys do it in, I mean, like
six seconds.
Six seconds. I mean, what? Why can't they do it in? I mean, can you imagine? And then you're like, wait. So I wouldn't want to build a business model out of doing a change of tires in 6 seconds.
No, absolutely not.
And again, I wouldn't want to build a business model and out of doing grand slam home runs as investments. Are they out there? Yes.
And I would even argue that it's detrimental to your future in this business.
Yeah.
If you come out of the gate with a grand slam.
Yes.
Because it seems to me everybody I know that's ever hit that grand slam on their first deal,
That's all they look for.
They never can repeat that again, and then they're out.
Right. All right. So if you are interested or you want to get more information about the Wealth Through Real Estate Academy that is this weekend, then I need you to email today support@rightpathrealestate. That's support@rightpathrealestate.com. support@rightpathrealestate.com.
Two things. Mm-hmm. If you're already in this industry and you're tired of not having anybody to go to when you get stuck, come see what we do. If you're getting in this industry, you have an interest in this industry, and you want to do it and never have to worry about being stuck, come see what we do.
Or if you feel like you don't have control over your financial future in terms of retirement and you've never looked at real estate before, then you need to give us a look
That's
as
being
well.
Stuck so, as well,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's being stuck. Absolutely. So, all right, guys, thanks for listening. I'll be here all day Saturday and Sunday at the Wealth Through Real Estate Academy, making a difference in other people's lives. Do you want to be next? Thanks for listening. Be back on Monday. Thanks, guys.
You've been listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. Find Tom at rightpathrealestate.com. You can put the fear behind you and listen every day from 9 to 10 a.m. on Business 1110 KTEK.